हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू परम गुरु पाठशाला इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सहरसा। माई सेल्फ चौहान दिग्विजय। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो प्रेजेंटेशन आई एम गोइंग टू टीच द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड टू। माई सब्जेक्ट इज इंग्लिश, यूनिट नंबर 4, जंबल सेंटेंसेस। ओके, जंबल सेंटेंसेस। टॉपिक्स कवर्ड हियर, एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ जंबल सेंटेंसेस। सो इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल आइडेंटिफाई, यू विल अरेंज सम जंबल सेंटेंसेस इनटू प्रॉपर ऑर्डर। ओके फ्रेंड्स, सो इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट सेंटेंसेस और स्टेटमेंट्स यू कैन से and questions. So now in this video we are going to learn about jumble sentences. Dear friends, now first of all read the group of words given below. Okay, here I have given some group of words, so you will have to arrange them in proper sentences. First of all, I am reading number A. Okay, a bicycle Rina riding is. A bicycle Rina riding is. Can you find any meaning of this group of words? Yes or no? No. Okay, now number B. With the chicks mother hen is. With the chicks mother hen is. Okay friends, do you get any meaning from this group of words? No, because they are not in proper sequence, not in proper order. So these are not sentences. Okay, these groups of words do not have any meaning. They do not make any sense. Do they make any kind of sense? No, they do not make any kind of sense. Okay, now friends, read the group of words given below. Here you will understand better. Okay, so here Rina is riding a bicycle. Here I have arranged the groups of words in proper order so that you can get proper meaning. So Rina is riding a bicycle. Rina kya kar rahi hai? Bicycle chala rahi hai. Okay, so you get meaning. Now number B, mother hen is with the chicks. Yes, do you get any meaning? Yes, mother hen is with the chicks. So these words make complete sense. This group of words make complete sense. So these words, when arranged in proper order, okay, these words when arranged in order make complete sense. They form a sentence. Okay, they form a sentence because they are arranged in proper order. It makes a complete sense. So we can say they form or they frame a sentence. Okay friends, so do get my point, what I want to say? Okay, the groups of words which do not have any meaning, they do not make any sense, they are not sentences. Okay, and these words make complete sense. Now come to next point. Now friends, you will have to arrange these words to form sentences. Okay, now first of all you will have to remember each sentence must begins with a capital letter, and you will also remember that put a question mark or full stop at the end. So don't forget either a question mark or a full stop at the end of each sentence. Okay, now I have given some examples so that you can understand it in a better way. Okay friends, so first example, your house where is, do you get any kind of meaning? Does it make complete sense? No. Your house where is, so if somebody asks like this, your house where is, do you get any meaning? No. But he or she will have to speak like this, where is your house? Yeah, where is your house? So friends, you will get proper meaning because it makes complete sense. Okay friends, now come to second example. A good John is boy. Do you get any meaning of this group of words? A good John is boy. No. So here you will have to remember begin each sentence with a capital letter. So John is a name of a boy. So here you will write J capital. John is a good boy. And at the end, what will you put? Yes, this is a sentence. So you will put a symbol of full stop. Okay, friends. Now, come to number three example. Beautiful country is my. Do you get any kind of meaning? Beautiful country is my answer. So here again, remember begin each sentence with a capital letter. So here you will first write like this, my. So M will be in capital. My country is beautiful. Yes, India is beautiful. You can say my country is beautiful. So after at the end you will put full stop. Okay, now come to next example. A toy car has he. Do you get any meaning? Does it make any sense? No. So you will have to arrange just like this. He has a toy car. So here again, remember begin each sentence with a capital letter and don't forget to put either a question mark or a full stop at the end of each sentence. So here he has a toy car. He has a toy car. So here he, H, you will write in capital letter, and after at the end you will put a symbol of full stop. Okay friends, have you understood or not? Okay, then we will see some more examples so you will get clear idea about it. Now number 5, sings a song C. Sings a song C. Do you get any idea? Does it make any kind of sense, these groups of words? No. So you will have to write like this, C sings a song. But here S is not in capital, so here you will write C S is in capital letter, and at the end don't forget to put full stop because it is a sentence. She sings a song. Okay friends, now come to next sentence. Brings the postman letters. Brings the postman letters. So here, do you get any kind of meaning? No. So brings the postman letters means, yes, postman tapali. Okay, डाकिया. डाकिया इसे बोलते हैं ना इंग्लिश में. वो डाकिया क्या लाता है? डाक, टपल लाता है ना. यस. सो हियर यू विल राइट टी एच ई इन में टी यू विल राइट इन कैपिटल. द पोस्टमैन ब्रिंग्स लेटर्स एंड एट द एंड यू विल पुट अ सिंबल ऑफ फुल स्टॉप. ओके फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी विल सी next example. Are what eating you? Do you get any kind of meaning? Are what eating you? No. So this is a question. Here we will put question mark at the end of this sentence. So first of all, remember each sentence begins with a capital letter. So here what, W, you will write in capital. You will start like this. What are you eating? Aap kya kha rahe ho? What are you eating? So W will be in capital letter. Okay, now okay, number 8. Your own Sunday is birthday. Does it make any kind of sense? Do you get any kind of meaning? This group of words, your own Sunday is birthday. No. So it must be written like this. Your birthday is on Sunday. So here in the word your, Y will be in capital. Okay, so your birthday is on Sunday. आपकी birthday, आपका जन्मदिन कब है? Sunday को है. Okay, so now look at one more example. Love I school my. Do you get any kind of meaning? This given group of words, love I school my, no. So how will you start? Yes, we will start with I. So I love my school, and at the end what will you put? Yes, full stop. So I love my school. Okay friends. So I must be written in capital, and here at the end after the word school the sentence ends, so it at the end we will put full stop. Okay, now come to next sentence. Beautiful a girl is Rashmika. Beautiful a girl is Rashmika. Does it make any kind of sense? Do you get any kind of meaning of this groups? No. So how will you start? Yes, Rashmika, you will start with the word Rashmika jo upar ke sentence mein at the end mein likha hai, to ab Rashmika se start karenge. Rashmika is a beautiful girl. So Rashmika is a beautiful girl. Rashmika sundar ladki hai. So at the end we will put full stop because it ends with a full stop because it is a sentence. Okay, now friends, I think you have been familiar with this group of words, how to arrange. Okay friends, so now you have been familiar with questions and sentence what. Okay, so I would like to give you one example, one homework. So you will have to arrange these words to form sentences. What will you have to do? So you will have to arrange these words to form sentences. आपको ये दिए गए words का use करके आपको एक इसमें से sentences बनाना है. You will have to begin each sentence with a capital letter. आपको sentence की शुरुआत किस letter से करनी है? Capital letter से. Okay, now put a question mark or a full stop at the end. You will have to put a question mark or a full stop at the end of each sentence. Okay, so you have been familiar with a question mark or and full stop, as we have learned about it in our previous videos. Okay, so can you do it or not? Yeah, obviously you can do it very easily. Although I am helping you, so go I every day to school. So how will you start? हम आई से स्टार्ट करेंगे. आई गो टू स्कूल एवरी डे. एट द एंड वी विल पुट फुल स्टॉप. ओके फ्रेंड्स, नाउ इज व्हाट द नेम स्कूल ऑफ योर. यस, डज इट मेक एनी काइंड ऑफ सेंस? नो. इज व्हाट द नेम ऑफ स्कूल ऑफ योर? सो हाउ विल यू राइट? यस, what is the name of your school? Yes, if I want to know the name of your school, I have to speak like this. What is the name of your school? And at the end you will put a symbol of a question mark because this is a question. Okay, now come to third one. Two eye pencils have. So how will you start? Yes, is this a sentence or a question? Yes, this is a statement, or you can say sentence. I have two pencils. You can write like this. I have two pencils, and at the end I will put a full stop. Okay friends, now come to fourth one. Do leave you where. So how will you start? Yes, from where. So where do you live? So W कैसे लिखेंगे? कैपिटल में. ओके, where do you live? आप कहाँ रहते हो? दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो एट द एंड आई विल पुट क्वेश्चन मार्क. where do you live? ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट वन. इज व्हाट नेम योर. इफ आई डू नॉट नो योर नेम, I want to know your name. I will ask you a question like this. What is your name? Yes, what is your name? So I will start with what, and what W I must write with a capital letter. Okay, what is your name? So at the end, I will put a question mark. Okay, friends, can you do it or not? Okay, very good. So you will write this exercise in your notebook and make another 5 sentences like this. You will put a question mark and full stop at the end of each sentence. Okay, now friends, I would like to conclude this video. Okay, thank you.